information testing. So if you will go in the Selenium, so we have a Selenium official, you know, this is official site for Selenium, the people who have developed the Selenium. Okay, so if you will go in over there, for it, we have a Selenium web driver, Selenium IDE, Selenium grid. So we will go inside the Selenium web driver. Okay, in Selenium web driver we can see how many languages, you know, we have. So Selenium support multiple language, you can see Selenium support multiple language. So we have a Ruby, we have a Java, we have a Python, we have a C#, and we have a JavaScript. So we are learning Java with respect to Selenium. If you don't know Java, you cannot able to do Selenium. Got it, right? So Selenium supporting like 5 language. Okay, so which language we are going to learn? We are going to learn Java. So now first we will understand how to install Java in your system. Okay, so go to the Google and download JDK 1.8 version. Okay, go there. Not here. Not in this site. I think so. They changed the UI part or what? Okay, this is your okay. So we have a, you know, different links. So like that, you can see I will share this link with you. Okay, so just I'm going to Notepad. So if you will download this Java, okay, so we can see we have a one exe file. Actually this is a not a JDK. I will send you the link. Okay, after class I will send you the link. This is a not a JDK, this is the JRE. Okay, so if you will install the JDK, then after that you have to, you know, after downloading the JDK you have to install the JDK on your system. So that part I will send you on the link, don't worry, where you have to go and install. So like this is the exe file. Okay, simply you have to, you know, click on that and you have to install. Okay, after installing that JDK software, okay, so if you will go in the C drive, we have a program file. In program file one folder is there, that is called Java folder. So after downloading, after installing, in C drive we have a one folder, that is called Java folder. If it is not there, means you did not install Java, you know, your Java is not installed in your system. Okay, and Java supporting multiple editor. Multiple editor means where you can write the code. Okay, where you can write the code. So I am using Edit Plus Editor. So this is your Edit Plus Editor. So I am using this Edit Plus Editor. So how to download this Edit Plus Editor? Just you can search on the Google Edit Plus Editor, download the this editor. Okay, if you are not able to download, let me know. This is like exe file. After you can install this, then you have to, you know, configure this Java in your Edit Plus. So how to configure? Go in this tools and we have a preferences. Inside this you can see we have a user tool. In user tool, okay, you can go here group name. So group name is by default group name, and you can click on this add tool and you can go in the program. So you can see you will get this option. So group name by default is this is the group name by default, it is there. Here you can write compile. Okay, and now we have this command. So just click on that and go in the C drive. Go in the C drive, and in C drive, same location, and program files Java. Go in this JDK bin folder, and you can see we have this file is there, that is called java.javac, right? And if you can open that, you will get this location. Okay, and after that, what you have to do, you have to go in the argument. Inside this argument, you have to choose this file name. Okay, and after that, again, you have to choose this one. Okay, so these things, and you can apply this. Again, you can go in the user tools. Okay, then here you can write execute. Okay, here you can write the execute. Again, you will go here. And again, you have to go in the C folder. Inside this C folder, we have a program folder. We have a Java. Inside this, we have a JDK bin. And we have this. Okay, for execution, you have to select this file. Okay, it looks like, you know, TCML, right? Then again, open that. Then again, you will get it like that. This location, you will get it. And after that, you have to select. You have to select from here file name not extension, like this one, and again you have to select same one. Okay, so this is the configuration of your how to configure for your practice purpose. So practice purpose I am using this editor, got it right? For practice purpose I used this editor. So now we will understand that. So what is JDK? So when you are installing the JDK software, so inside this JDK software you will get this thing. Okay, if you will install the JDK software, JDK means Java Development Kit. So when you will install, when you will download the JDK software in your system, we have a compiler, we have a JRE, and we have a JVM. These are the things is there. Okay, so you can see in this C folder we have program files, we have a Java folder, and we have a two folder, JDK and JRE, right? We have a two folder, JDK and JRE. So here you can see we have a JRE and this JDK. So this is the inbuilt software. When you will install this JDK software, all the software by default it is there. Got it right? So now we will understand how to start your Java coding. Okay, so now if you will go in this same location I'm going. Okay, so these are the things I will come on that. So this is your Edit Plus software, and how to start Java coding. You can see go in the file, and we have a Java, select this. Okay, just after that by default this code will come. So I am writing something like bank test. Okay, and this file I am going to save this. So how to save this file? This is your class keyword, and this is your class name. How to save this file? Just copy this and control S, and you have to save same class name. Sorry, not copied. Just I'm copy this. Okay, so now I'm going to save this. So, you know, I did not tell you how to save this file. You can see we have a many extension is there, but we use Java dot, you know, extension. Okay, we use this extension dot Java extension, right? So this is your Java file. So now I save this file. Now we will understand what is this. What do you meaning of this line of the code? Okay, so just I'm going to remove this part. So I have removed that. So you can see we have a one keyword that is called class keyword. So question is why we are writing this class keyword. This is your class keyword and this is your real world object. Real world object, you can write anything. If you will speak in the Java language, this is called your class name. So first question is why we are writing this class keyword. Okay, so you can see these are the real world object. These are the real world object, right? Same computer, bank, employee, railway, flight, cab. Okay, these are the real world object. Simply I can give you the one example. Okay, so I want to start my business. Sorry, I opened that calculator. I want to start my business. Okay, so I want to start one e-commerce or one net banking application. So my bank is completely like a net banking. This is not a physical, only we have a net banking, right? So what happened? Or you can like, I'm going to start online e-commerce business, right? So what happened? So we have a one, you know, business, like I have some requirement. So my requirement will tell to the software company, right? What is my requirement? You know, because if you will start any business, you need a one application. So Java is called object oriented programming language. So what do you meaning of that? So you can see if you will go in the Amazon, this is your real world object, right? This is our real world object. But you can see how many this real world object or our business is automated, right? So this real world object or this business is automated. What do you meaning of automation, right? If you want to automate anything, we need a programming, right? So automation means simply you can go through this website and you can search any product if you want. If it is available, you will add in the cart. This is the one logic. You can add number of product here, you can delete number of product here. So these are the what? Real-time business, right? So this real-time business, so if you will go in the real-time business, and these are the real world object. So Java, why Java is called object-oriented programming language? Because any real world object we can convert into the programming world. Okay, so I can give you the example of this, right? This real world object, this programming world, right? So you can say net banking, automated, HDFC bank. This e-commerce, automated, right? So how we can represent this real world object into the programming world? So we have a one class keyword. Okay, so we have a like 53 keyword in the Java. So we have a this class keyword. So this class keyword represent real world object into the programming world. Got it, right? So why we are writing this class keyword? So these are the real world object, and these real world object we have converted into the programming world. How to represent real world object into the programming world? By using this class keyword. Do you have any question? Why we write class keyword? Sraf, you have any question regarding this class keyword? No. Any question? Okay. So you can see B have a blocks also. Block, open and curly braces. So if you are this block opening and closing, this block inside this block is called class field. Class. Okay, this block is called class field. Now we will understand what do meaning of this class field, what you can write inside this, right? So now how to execute Java code. You can see we have this dot class file. Okay, now if you will write anything inside this class field, so I told you, right, when you install the JDK, we have a compiler, we have a JRE, and we have a JVM. So now we will understand what do you meaning of compiler, and what is the job of compiler, and what is the use of JVM. JRE we will understand later. So now we will understand compiler and JVM. What is the job of this software? So now what we can do, if you will write anything here, right? And so we have a shortcut here, okay? This is the comment, you can comment this. So in edit plus software we have a shortcut, that shortcut is once again for compilation we will use control 1. If you will press control 1, so now my code will compile. So your question is, what is the meaning of compiler? You can see I wrote something here, but when I compile the code, means when I press control 1, I am getting some error. We have some error, right? This is the error. So what is the job of compiler? Compiler job is, it is checking the syntax of the code. Okay, compiler job is, it is checking the syntax of the code. If you are writing something wrong or your syntax is wrong, then it will throw compile time error. See, that's why in JDK software we have a compiler. So what is the compiler job? So compiler job is, it is checking the syntax of the code, right? It is checking the syntax of the code. If anything you have written wrong or this is not matching with Java, then what happened? Compiler will throw compile time error. This is the first job of the compiler, you can see. So this is the first job of the compiler, right? But I am getting this error. If I can press 1, you can see this compiler is telling, boss, you have written wrong code. This is not a syntax. The Java is not able to understand what you have written. Got it, right? So now this is the wrong syntax. So first job of compiler is, it will check the syntax of the code. Okay. Syntax of code. Okay, so I just am removing this all the part, again I am coming on that. Okay, so now first understand one job of the compiler. So now where you are, just I am going to execute this code, right? Still we are in dot java file. I try to compile my code but not able to compile because of some syntax error was there, right? So now I'm writing something here, okay? I am writing something here. So you can see we have something here. So this is called system. So system is a inbuilt class, and out is a variable, and println is a method. So you see we have inbuilt classes given by the Java people. We have a huge library for the Java. Okay, so system is a class, and out is a variable and println is a method. So coming session we will discuss. Okay, so use of this statement is it will print anything on your console. Got it, right? So system is a inbuilt class, out is a variable and println is a method. Got it? So this is your inbuilt class, inbuilt statement. So by using this inbuilt statement we will print this. Okay, so my question is, if I will try to print, so first what you have to do, we have to compile the code. If your code is not compiled successfully, you cannot execute your code. So if you are writing Java code, so we need to do two things. One is your compilation and one is your execution. Okay, so you need to do two things. One is your compilation and one is your execution. So if I will compile this code now, you can see the problem. I'm getting a still error. See, this error is coming. Illegal start type, cannot write this. So we are learning what you can write here, what you cannot write here. Got it, right? So question is, why we are getting this error? Why we are getting this error? So we will understand this. Okay, so first point, as a class level, okay, this is your class field, right? This is your class field. Okay, class field. In class field, so I can write one second. Okay, normal text. So first point is, as a class field, we can not write logic. Logic means system dot out dot println, system dot s by so. Okay, first point is your if you are starting Java coding, we need JDK software, right? Second point is, after download download JDK and install in your system, and download edit plus software. Okay, so after that what you have to do, you have to create a new file. Then how to create file? Go to file. Okay, go to file, and after that you need to go in new, right? Then you again click on new, you will get Java file. And how to save this file? By using Java class name. By using class name, and after that we will execute that code, right? We will execute that code. How to execute that code? So we have a, and what is class keyword, right? So we have a one class keyword, right? So class keyword is your, why we are writing this class keyword? Java is object oriented programming language. So if you want to represent real world object in programming world, real world object in programming world, then that's why we use what class keyword. In class keyword, okay, what you can write as a class field, we cannot write a logic like system.out.println. So what is meaning of this, you know, system.out.println, right? So system.out.println is a logic developed by the Java people. So what you can write inside this, okay? So I am getting this error. So you know how to print this statement. How to print this statement? So Java people have given one concept called method concept. Okay, don't understand what I am writing. Okay, right now don't understand what I am writing, just listen. Okay, because you will not understand what I am writing. Okay, so just you have to understand, because of this error, you know, so Java people have given one concept called method concept. Okay, so how to create a method and all, don't understand anything now what I am writing. So login page, okay, just you have to understand this is your method name. And method means, why method is required? If you have any logic, so logic means we have two types of the logic. One is your business logic and one is your mathematical logic. So we have two types of the logic. One is your business logic and one is your mathematical logic. If you want to write any logic, then we have to create a method. We cannot write a logic as a class level. So before I was creating this logic, right, as a class level. So here just I am writing this, I am removing this because I was getting this error here. Okay, so here we are getting this compile time error, right? So here just understand here what, if you want to write any logic, then we must create a method. Okay, so how to create a method? So I will tell you in the coming classes, so not worry. Here what you have to worry, you can see this block is called method block. You can see this block is called class block, and this block is called method block. Okay, this opening and curly braces, this is your method name. Why we use the method? Because we cannot write a logic as a class level, so that's why we create a method. So you should not understand what is a static void, and just to understand this is your user defined method. Okay, this is called your user defined method. So inside this, so this is called your method. Now I have written login page will be displayed. Okay, login page will be displayed. So now before I was not able to compile, now I'm again going to press Control 1. See, now I am not getting any error, means I reached on these steps. Okay, I am successfully compiled my code. So when you compile this code, then what happened? Compiler, you know, we have a, what is the job of compiler? We have a job of the compiler is, like, you know, first it will check the syntax of the code. If anything went wrong, then it will throw the compile time error. If everything is fine, your code is compiled successfully, then what happened? One file will be generated by compiler. That file is called .class file. Okay, that file is called .class file. So when I go over there, then you can see here, when you compile this code, okay, when you compile this code, when you compile this code, not this, okay, so where I am saving that file I want to show you, okay, so when you compile this code, one file will be generated, that is called dot class file. This file is nothing but this is your bytecode. So bytecode is only able to understand this Java virtual machine. Got it, right? So this is the, you know, dot class file is generated. So what is the job of compiler? Compiler will check the syntax of the code. If any error is there, your code won't be compiled successfully. So if there is no error, your code will compile successfully, then compiler will generate dot class file. This dot class file will interact with Java virtual machine. Okay, this dot class file will interact with Java virtual machine. Okay, so now my job is to how to interact with Java virtual machine. Now I am able to compile this code. If I will press 1, able to compile, compilation is done, dot class file is generated, and I want to execute. When you are, if you have any Java code, your code must, you know, you have to compile the code and you have to execute. So now if I will press here control, you know, 2, control 2, so it will execute my code. You can see if I will press control 2, but you can see still I'm getting some error. Okay, you can see. So we are still here. Okay, we are still here. We are not able to reach in console, means output. So still I am going to interact with Java virtual machine. Okay, so Java virtual machine, but I execute this code, again I am getting some error. You can see main method not found in class bank. Please define the main method. So we will understand this, why main method is required, right? So here we have your Java code. Just we'll understand. This is my Java code, like class. This is your Edit Plus software or any editor. Okay, this is your Edit Plus software or any editor, you can take it, no problem. This is my Edit Plus software. I am writing this code here. Okay, like I have written some code, class bank test. I have written here code, and now just I have created one method also here. Just I'm not writing complete code, just understand, or I will write this, no problem, a static m1. Okay, so I have written some code here in my Edit Plus software, or here we have a SOPLN. I'm printing this m1. Okay, I'm printing this m1. So what happened? This is your Edit Plus software, or this is you, user, you are there. Okay, and you are developer or you are user. So you are there, this is the user. So this, I am the user, I have written this code. Okay, in your system Java is there. So we, what happened, I compile this code here, compilation is done, When you compile this code, then what happens? One file will be generated. That file is called bank test dot class. So this file is nothing but this is your bytecode. Okay, this bytecode only able to understand the JVM. Only bytecode, read JVM. Okay, JVM will read only bytecode. So now, what happened? My bytecode is generated. So what happened? Now we need to interact with Java Virtual Machine. So this is our Java Virtual Machine. Okay. What is this? Okay, I can. Okay, this is my Java Virtual Machine. Okay, then this Java Virtual Machine, we have to interact with our code. This is your JVM. This is your JVM. But the question is how to interact with this. Okay, so when you are writing this code, so Java, your means we are the user and we need to interact with the JVM. I will tell you why we need to interact with JVM, because you are completely new in Java, so I'm not explaining all the things in one shot, otherwise you are not able to understand. So now we will understand why we required, why we are interacting. Because we have, so what happened, this JVM people have developed one method that is called common method, that is called main method. Okay, you can see what error we are getting here. Main method not found in class. Please define the main method. So simply what you have to understand, when you execute your code, okay, when you execute your code in your system, then inside this JVM software we have a logic for the main method. Okay, so when you if you want to interact with the JVM, you can see, if you are going in your office, right, we cannot enter directly in our office. We have some access, we have some security guard, we need to display our ID card, then we can enter that. Same thing here also. If you want to interact with JVM, if you want to enter in your office, then you have to access your card or you have to take the permission of your security guard. You cannot directly enter this. So here my ID card is mediator between, for entering in my office. If you don't have an ID card, then we need to take the permission of the security guard. They will give you the, temporary ID card, right? So if you want to interact with the JVM, so JVM have given one common method that is called main method. If you are not using this main method, you cannot interact with the JVM. If you don't have an ID card, then you cannot enter in your company. So same thing happened with here. When you are executing in your code, then we need to a main method. The question is coming one word called method. Okay, so tomorrow we will, I will explain you some method part, why method is required. So now this main method I will write in this code here. Okay, method will be created as a class level. You cannot create a method inside this method. Okay, you can see one method, this is the user defined method and this is your inbuilt method. Okay, this method is given by the Java people. Okay, So got it. So you should not understand what is public, static, void, main and all. Okay, just you have to understand this is your main method, because you are not able to understand all the code. Just we need to, you know, execute our code. Okay, so now we are learning how to execute our code. Got it, right? So this is your inbuilt method. You should not understand anything because you are not able to understand this code completely. So what is the agenda of today? How to install your JDK and configure in your Edit Plus. Second thing, how to start your Java code. Okay, what is the class keyword? As a class level, what we can write, by what we cannot write. If I am able to write, cannot write a logic as a class level, we need to create a method. So we have a two types of the method. One is your user defined method and one is your inbuilt method. So why we use the method? Because if you want to write any logic, then Java people have given one concept called method concept. So you should not understand what is public and all. Just you have to understand this is your user defined method and this is your inbuilt method. You have a one question. Hey, still I have user defined method. Why main method is required? This is also method. This is also method. Then why the Java is looking for only main method? What is the reason of that? Because this is also method, right? User defined method. Why it is not able to interact with JVM? So the problem is this JVM is a software, not a human beings. So JVM doesn't know which method you are going to create. We have a multiple types of the method. This is your static, we have a non-static method, many types of the method are there. But JVM doesn't know which method you are going to create. Then JVM software, who has developed the JVM, they have developed inside this JVM common method that is called main method. So that's why we required main method. When you execute your code, JVM and compiler always looks like where is your main method. Got it, right? So if I will compile this code, I'm able to compile and I will to execute. See, this is executing. Your question is why it is not executing? Because this is your user defined method. User defined method will not execute automatically, but this main method will execute automatically. Okay, so now this user defined method, how to execute, how to execute and all. So we will see in the tomorrow session. Okay, so this is your little bit introduction about of Java, how to start your code. But don't worry about of that, you are not able to understand this all the things. Coming session you will get clarity about of all the things whatever I have written right now. Okay, now do you have any question? Have any question?